Sairam children, so today, from today we are going to start our revision of English. Today we are going to revise our new voices portion. Chapter number 3, 4, 5 and 7. These four chapters are there for your S7 online exams. So we are going to cover that chapters in our revision. Part 1 we are going to cover today. Let's start. First question. As you know children, you have to click on the correct option. Since it's an online exam, you have to click on the correct option. And you have done it before, so it will be quite easy for you now. And you all are comfortable, I'm sure. So let's see the first question. What is an unrewarding chore? In the poem, an elephant is hard to hide. What is an unrewarding chore in the poem, an elephant is hard to hide? Three options are given, A, B and C. Read all the options carefully, think about the answer, and then you have to press click on the correct option. Option A is trying to put an elephant in a drawer. Option B, to give peanuts to the elephant. Or option C, to bring an elephant to home. What is an unrewarding chore? Option A is the correct answer. Trying to put an elephant in a drawer is an unrewarding chore in the poem. An elephant is hard to hide. Second question is, what is better than a drawer? In the poem, an elephant is hard to hide. And the options given are a bed, a closet, or a kitchen. We have seen that the poet tried to put an elephant to hide it from the parents, isn't it? So, what is better than a drawer? You cannot cram it in a drawer. So, in the poem, an elephant is hard to hide. What is better than a drawer? Which is the place? It's option B, a closet. And the meaning of a closet we have seen is a type of wardrobe. Third question is, what has the speaker Jack Prelutsky brought home? The options are a tiger, an elephant, or a rabbit. What has the poet Jack Prelutsky brought home? Answer is option B, an elephant. So we have clicked on option B. Next question is, who is Nazim? The given options are A, Horja's brother, B, Horja's son, C, Horja's neighbor. Who is Nazim? Very simple. It is option C, Horja's neighbor. Fifth question is, what type of clothes did Horja give to Nazim? Nazim was giving some excuses, right? Because he didn't want to go to the court. So first he said that he is so old that he cannot walk to the court. So Nazim told that, okay, I'll give you my donkey to ride and we will go. But then also he said, what the next excuse he said that I gave? That I cannot go to the court in this shabby clothes. I don't have new clothes to go to the court and stand in front of judge, so I will not come. So to solve this problem, Nazim gave him some clothes, no? So what type of clothes did he give? A new woolen clothes, a new silken dress, or an old silken dress.
इट्स ऑप्शन बी अ न्यू सिल्कन ड्रेस. क्वेश्चन सिक्स, होम डिड होर्जा फाइंड सिटिंग ऑन हिज डोर स्टेप आफ्टर रिटर्निंग फ्रॉम द कोर्ट. टू होम डिड होर्जा फाइंड सिटिंग ऑन हिज डोर स्टेप. ऑप्शन ए द जज, ऑप्शन बी नाजीम और ऑप्शन सी डोंकी. इट इज ऑप्शन बी नाजीम. द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी. क्वेश्चन सेवन, हु पुश द मर्चेंट आउट ऑफ द कोर्ट. हु पुश द मर्चेंट आउट ऑफ द कोर्ट. When in the court, both Nazim and Horja tried to put their side, isn't it? So, but at the end, Horja cleverly, he proved his point so nicely that the judge got annoyed with Nazim. Then, Nazim was pushed out of the court. But who pushed the merchant out of the court? Was it Horja, the guards or the judge? Answer is the guards, option B. Okay, because the judge ordered the guards to push him out of the court. So option B is the correct answer. Eighth question, the opposite word of busy is A unbusy, B idle, C engaged. Be careful children, think about it, try to recall what we learnt. The opposite word of busy is option B idle. Ninth question, past tense of hug is hugged, option A, option B hugged. Just give attention to the spellings children. Or option C, hugged. A, B or C option is the correct answer. Past tense of hug. You are right. It is option B. H-U-G-G-E-D. Hugged is the correct answer. Tenth question. Why was Peter crying? Option A, because his mother scolded him. Option B, because his father refused to get him a dog. Or option C, his teacher scolded him. Why was Peter crying? And the correct answer is option B, because his father refused to get him a dog. Let's move to the 11th question. What did Peter's friends do when he told them about Sniffy? In Peter's ghost dog lesson, Peter was very happy and excited to see Sniffy and he wanted to show it to his friends. So he took him to the garden to show it to his friends. But when he told his friends about Sniffy, what was his friends' reaction? What did he do? What did they do when he told them about Sniffy? Were they started playing with it? Or were they laughed at him? Or were they ran away from there? Which is the correct answer? Option B is the correct answer. They laughed at him. Why did they laugh at him? Yes, because they were not able to see Sniffy. That's why they laughed at him. That what Peter is talking about. He is talking about his pet dog Sniffy. But they were not able to see it. So they laughed at him. 12th question. By what name was Mary called at home? What is the nickname of Mary? Is it option A, Maina? Option B, Manya? Or option C, Bronya? The correct answer is option B, Manya. 13th question. Correct meaning for the word effortlessly is differently, easily or quietly, effortlessly. Mary could read the passage of her sister effortlessly, isn't it? So, what is the correct answer here? Is it differently, easily or quietly? It's very simple, easily. Option B is the correct answer. So, we clicked on option B. 14th question is, click on the correct option for who said the following words to whom. And the sentence given is, I did not do that on purpose. I did not do that on purpose. You remember, children, from which chapter this sentence is taken from? Got it? Yes, recently we have seen this chapter, right? This is from chapter 7, Marie Curie. So, who said these words? Option A, father said to mother, Mary said to her parents, or Zosia said to Bronya. Who said these words? Option B is the correct answer. Mary said to her parents. 15th question. Rhyming word for bed is? Is it out? Option A, option B, head, or option C, bit? Rhyming word for bed is? Option B, head. It is option B, head. Now, children, today we have covered 15 questions in our revision session. Tomorrow, in part 2 of NBE revision, we are going to cover some more questions. But before that, I would like to remind one thing, that you have to go through the content of every book thoroughly in order to understand the questions that will be asked. It means you have to read the textbooks thoroughly, read all the lessons carefully, solve the exercises which was given in my videos or given below the exercises, so that it will be easy for you to attempt all the questions and answer them correctly. So, remember to go through the content of every book thoroughly in order to understand the questions that will be asked. So, study well, go through the portion again and again and prepare for the exam. I wish all of you best of luck. Let's stop here. Sai Ram.